Good morning, children. Welcome back to our social class. So, in today's session, we are going to start lesson 2 in geography, and the name of the chapter is atmosphere. So, first of all, what is atmosphere? The layer of the air surrounding the earth is called as atmosphere. So, this is held due to the gravity of the earth. So, when compared to the earth, the atmosphere is a very thin layer. Okay, and as the height increases, the density of the atmosphere decreases. So, in this lesson, first we are going to discuss about the composition of air and then about the greenhouse gases. So, first about the composition of air. So, about 78% of the air is nitrogen. Okay, and 21% of oxygen and remaining 1% is of other gases. So, what are the gases in the atmosphere? Nitrogen, oxygen, argon, carbon dioxide, neon, ozone, hydrogen, helium and methane. And including water vapor and dust particles. This makes our gases in the atmosphere. And next we are going to discuss about the structure of the atmosphere. So, first it starts with the lowest layer of the earth, troposphere. So, this layer is the closest to the earth. Next will be the stratosphere. So, this stratosphere, it protects us from the harmful ultraviolet radiations from the sun. So, next to the stratosphere is the mesosphere. So, this is the coldest layer of the atmosphere. Okay, and the meteors in the space, they burn in this layer. Okay, children. And the next layer is the thermosphere. So, here the radio waves are sent back to the earth. And the last one is the exosphere. So, here it consists of the ionized particles. Okay. And this is about the structure and about the composition of air. So, next we are going to discuss about the greenhouse effect. So, what is this greenhouse effect? So, can you see the factories here? And the smoke leaves from the factories. And here it is the sun. The radiation of the sun is absorbed by the land. Okay, and this is the greenhouse gases present in the atmosphere. So, what is this greenhouse effect? The trapping of heat energy by the atmosphere so as to prevent the earth from becoming too cold at night is called the greenhouse effect. And what are the gases present in the greenhouse effect? Carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, CFCs, methane and water vapor.
And the next thing what we are going to see in this lesson is about global warming and ozone depletion. So under global warming, we'll see what is global warming, the cause, the impact and the measures to control global warming. And next to ozone depletion. So the ozone hole, what is an ozone hole? That we are going to see what are the causes and what is this Montreal Protocol? Why was it signed? Okay, so all these things we are going to see in this lesson. Okay, children, now let's see the lesson in detail. So, children, we already learned about what is atmosphere, isn't it? So, the envelope of air which surrounds the earth is called the atmosphere. And it is held to the earth due to gravity. And we also know that the size of the earth when compared to the atmosphere, how it is, children, it is a very thin layer, isn't it? And so its exact thickness is unknown till now. And it is estimated that the upper limit of the atmosphere is at a height of about 1600 kilometers from the mean sea level. And the density of air decreases with increase in height. The next one is about the composition of air. So, this also we have already discussed. Okay, children. So, the atmosphere is a mixture of colorless, odorless and a tasteless gas. And the composition of air is not uniform. And it varies from place to place and from time to time. And it is composed of gases, water vapor, dust particles and smoke, as I told you already. And we also discussed about the gases present in the atmosphere. Okay, so of these gases, nitrogen is 78% and oxygen is 21%. So they are the two main gases, and other gases as I showed you in the figure on the board, it is only 1%. Okay, children. And the heavier gases like oxygen, water vapor, and dust particles are found in the lower layers of the atmosphere. And at many places, impurities like smoke, salts, carbon monoxide, and other chemicals are also found. So children, next we are going to see about the structure of the atmosphere. So the atmosphere has a layered structure, and on the basis of the composition, density and temperature, the atmosphere can be divided into 5 layers. How many layers? 5 layers, and they are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and the last one is exosphere. Can you see in the figure, children? Yes. Now let's discuss about each of these layers in detail. So children, can you see the figure here? It is the structure of the atmosphere and the distribution of temperature in it. Okay. So first one, can you find troposphere there? Yes. It is the lowest layer of and the closest to the Earth's surface, and it extends from the mean sea level up to the height of about 8 kilometers over the poles and about 18 kilometers over the equator. And the temperature in this layer decreases with increase in height above the mean sea level. Okay, and thus troposphere is the home of clouds and lightning and other weather phenomena occurs here. The next one is stratosphere. So the stratosphere lies above the troposphere and it extends to a height of about 50 kilometers, okay, and from the mean sea level. And this layer is almost free from all types of weather phenomena, and the movement of the air is generally horizontal. And the jet planes fly in this layer. Okay, and the lower part of the stratosphere has concentration of ozone. I told you, no, while explaining on the board. So it protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. Okay, this you have to keep in your mind. Next one is mesosphere. So this mesosphere lies above the stratosphere and it extends from about 50 kilometers to about 80 kilometers above the mean sea level. And the temperature decreases with the increase in height and reaches to about minus 100 degrees Celsius. And this is the coldest layer, and the meteors which come from outer space burn up in this layer. Okay. And the next one will be thermosphere. What is this thermosphere? It lies above the mesosphere and it extends for about 80 kilometers to about 400 kilometers above the mean sea level. And in this layer, the temperature increases with increase in height and it reaches up to 1500 degrees Celsius. And the part of the thermosphere is called ionosphere as it has ionized molecules. Okay, and this layer reflects low frequency radio waves back to the earth and thus helps in long distance communication. And next one will be exosphere. So the exosphere is the uppermost layer and it gradually merges into the outer space, and very light gases like hydrogen, helium are found here. And this layer, the temperature increases with height and it may reach about 4500 degree Celsius. Okay, children. Now I'll show you some clips regarding this troposphere, mesosphere, and thermosphere. So, children, this is troposphere, where the weather phenomena occurs in this layer of the atmosphere. Okay. And children, the meteors burn up in the mesosphere and appear as the bright streaks of light in the night sky. Okay, and this mesosphere lies above the stratosphere, as I told you before. Okay, and what you have to remember, it is the coldest layer. So children, can you see this beautiful night sky? How it is? Too colorful and vibrant to see, isn't it? Yes. So this natural light seen in the night sky is called this aurora borealis or the northern lights. So it occurs in the thermosphere and exosphere when the electrically charged particles from the sun collide with atmospheric oxygen and nitrogen. So So next we are going to see about importance of atmosphere. So the atmosphere is important to us in the following ways. First one, the lowest layer of the atmosphere has oxygen, which is essential for breathing. So this you already know, and it protects us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun, and it softens the sun's glare, that is the shade entering during the day. And it keeps the earth's surface warm even at night, and it helps in the change of weather, and it helps to transmit the sound waves, and it shields us from the meteors. So now an interesting topic, greenhouse effect. Okay, so first of all, what is a greenhouse? A greenhouse is a glass house used in cold areas to preserve heat and thus to grow plants. And the glass allows shortwave solar radiation to enter the greenhouse, and it does not allow a long wave radiation to move out. Thus, the air temperature inside the greenhouse is more than the air temperature outside. So, a part of the sun's energy which is emitted as the heat radiation reaches the earth's surface, and a part of this heat energy is absorbed and it's retained by the earth's surface. Okay, children, and there is an energy balance between the heat energy that reaches the earth's surface and the heat energy that is re-radiated from the earth into space. So this energy balance determines the temperature on the earth's surface, and it is important and necessary to maintain the temperature on the earth's surface within a range. And can you see the picture of a French scientist there? He is JBG Fourier, and he assumed that the earth is a giant greenhouse, and the earth's atmosphere traps the heat energy that comes from the sun and prevents the earth from becoming too cold at night. And this is known as the greenhouse effect. And there are gases which absorb the heat energy and maintain a livable temperature on the earth. So those gases are called what? Greenhouse gases. Example, carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbons, methane and water vapor. So the next topic will be global warming. So the excess accumulation of the greenhouse gases in the atmosphere disturbs the energy balance. So this can increase the heat and cause the rise in air temperature. So this increase in air temperature due to excessive concentration of the greenhouse gases is called global warming. And the four major activities that produce the greenhouse gases are agriculture, energy use, industrial process and deforestation. So now we are going to discuss about the key factors, that is the impact of global warming. First one is rise in sea level. So you all know that since there is an increase in temperature, what will happen? The snow-capped mountains and the glaciers, they all melt. So it will lead to the rise in the sea level and flooding in most of the coastal areas. Okay. And next one is change in agriculture. So there is a shift in the temperature, that as the temperature rises up, what will happen? It will slowly affect the wheat growing areas, and the pattern, rainfall pattern, everything will change, and this will affect the crop yields and the type of crops cultivated. Okay, children. Next one is the climate change. So as the earth heats up, the world's climatic pattern will change drastically. And you know, the number of countries in the last summer, what happened? The heat wave has raised up. So we have seen in the past 2 years about the Amazon forest fires and many fires all around, isn't it? Next one is shortage of fresh water. So the freshwater resources may be diminished due to shrinking mountain glaciers and reduced snow cover. So the rising sea levels may pollute fresh surface and groundwater supplies with the salt water. Okay, children. Next one is increased health risk. So millions of people around the world will be under the increased risk of many diseases. So like malaria, dengue, yellow fever and other infectious diseases. Okay. And next one is loss of biodiversity. So most of the plants and animal species grow and develop in a specific temperature range, and the global warming may force many of them to shift slowly towards high altitude or latitude, and many of these species may even become extinct. Extinct means what? To become no more. Okay, it is not there. And the last one is about increase in the evaporation rate. So the water in the lakes and rivers and other water bodies would evaporate faster due to increase in the air temperature, and it can also cause changes in the characteristics of the ocean currents. So the next topic what we are going to discuss is about the measures taken to control this global warming. So what we have to do, we have to use alternative energy resource in place of coal and petroleum. So naturally, if you're going to use this coal and petroleum to a full extent, what will happen, children? So continuously, if you're digging out everything, so one day what will happen? It will not be there for anyone to use. So you have to think of an alternative energy resource. Okay. Next one, reduction in the quantity of chemical fertilizers and insecticides used to grow crops. We have to reduce the chemical fertilizers and we have to depend upon nature. Next one, reduction in deforestation, especially of the tropical rainforest, which absorbs much of carbon dioxide present in the atmosphere, where we had the recent forest fire in Brazil, isn't it? So we have to plant more trees in these areas, that is the deforested areas. And the last one is to find alternative materials such as the hydrofluorocarbons, which can possibly reduce the release of the chlorofluorocarbons in the environment. Okay. So what is this, children? This is about ozone depletion. So ozone, O3, occurs naturally throughout the atmosphere, but its maximum concentration is 90% in the stratosphere. And the average thickness of the ozone layer is about 2.9 millimeters. And the thickness of the ozone layer is measured in Dobson unit, that is DU. So 1 DU is equal to 0.01 millimeters thick. And compressed ozone gas is around the earth at 0 degrees Celsius and at an atmospheric pressure of 760 millimeters of the mercury column. And the vertical column thickness of the ozone layer is about 220 Dobson unit and it is considered as normal. So if the thickness of the ozone layer in the stratosphere falls below 220 DU, Dobson unit, then it is termed as ozone hole. Okay, children, can you understand? I'll repeat the sentence again. If the thickness of the ozone layer in the atmosphere falls below 220 Dobson unit, then it is termed as ozone hole. Okay. So, children, you all know now what is ozone depletion and about the ozone hole. Okay. So, what are the causes of this ozone depletion? So the main pollutants responsible for the depletion of the ozone layer are the chlorofluorocarbons, nitrogen oxide from the fertilizers, and hydrocarbons from the fossil fuels. And these chlorofluorocarbons are used as a coolant in refrigerators, air conditioners, fire extinguishing equipments, foam insulation, and the aerosol propellants. So they are also produced by jet engines, motor vehicles, and industrial activities. So the greatest depletion of the ozone layer occurs over the Antarctic region during the spring season. Okay. And the ozone depletion is almost nil above the equator. This you have to keep in your mind. So next we are going to discuss about the Montreal Protocol. So in September 1987, 34 industrialized nations signed the Montreal Protocol. Why was it signed? So it was aimed to phase out the use of ozone depleting substances and to find or develop non-toxic substances. What do you mean by toxic? Poisonous. Okay, so its aim is to develop non-toxic, non-poisonous substances. So there are some things to follow and to protect the ozone layer. Now let's see it. So some things that we can do to protect the ozone layer are as follows. So first, we have to make sure that the old refrigerators and air conditioners which we are using in our home should be safely disposed by giving them to a recycling yard. Okay. And next one, the technicians must ensure that while repairing refrigerators and air conditioners, they recover and recycle the ozone depleting substances. And these ozone depleting substances should not be released in the atmosphere. And next one, When repairing or renovating your house, make sure that the old insulation foams containing the ozone depleting substances are disposed of as environmentally hazardous waste. Okay, children. And the last one, inform yourself and increase awareness of the problem of ozone depletion, and you have to initiate the necessary action. So there's a famous proverb, isn't it? Be the change what you want the world to be. So as a student of our prestigious institution, what you have to do? You should be a good student as well as a good human being in the world, and you are going to be the change what the world wants. Okay, children? So start, initiate the action and make the world green. Okay. So we have come to the end of the session, children. So write your classwork neatly with legible handwriting. So children, in this lesson we have discussed about what is atmosphere, the layers of the atmosphere, the composition of air, and about the structure of the atmosphere. And under greenhouse effect, we saw what is greenhouse effect and about the greenhouse gases. Next, we discussed about global warming. What is global warming? What are the causes, impact, and measures to control global warming? And the last topic was ozone depletion. We discussed what is a ozone hole, what are the causes for ozone depletion, and the last one was about the Montreal Protocol. Okay, children. Thank you and have a great day. Complete the activity given in your assignment.